So today's video is, it's turning into a yearly tradition. Now, for those of you that don't know, I started rowing at Weybridge Rowing Club when I was sort of 14, 15 years old. And one of my first rowing partners at that club was a guy called Matt. Now, since sort of university and becoming adults, we don't get to see each other as much as we would probably like to. We like hanging around with each other. We've known each other for a long time now. So we decided we'll create a yearly tradition. And that tradition is to come together at the old stomping ground at Weybridge Rowing Club. Every year on New Year's Eve, we'll just throw a workout together. It could be on the ergos, it could be some floor work, could be incorporating some cross training in there, whatever. We just get a whiteboard, jot down any ideas, and we crush that, and then we can go out, have some guilt-free food and drink, and just sort of catch up, and it's nice. So that's the plan for today. I need to head out now, jump in the car, drive to Weybridge, I'll meet Matt there, and we'll try and figure out a workout. That is dirty. I am not standing in that. There's a bit of dog poo down there as well. The wood. Jacket. Bag. Excuse me a minute. And shoes. Okay. We're good to go. There she is. This is where it all began for me. Water quite high at the moment, not very safe. But yeah, I love coming back down here. Lots of good memories. Upstairs. I'm a little bit late. Got stuck in quite a lot of traffic on the motorway trying to get here. So Matt should be upstairs and we'll try and figure out a workout. Be the structure.
Did you go to Junior Worlds?
No, I went straight to Junior Worlds. Boom. But yeah, Nick, Paul told me to go up there so I could guess be around juniors that are going through the same process.
Is there anyone going through this one?
Yeah, Joe and Cookie in a pair.
Yeah.
I was with Dom, and we had Luke and Piers Barnett. Lucian O'Donoghue.
Yeah.
There's another pair. You also had the Wed Lakes, who are always out in force in their singles.
Black digital camo, yellow R. Where am I going to show you? Row Elite down the side leggings, and every athlete can have their national flag on the back. And over here we have Matt Beagley, stretching on the floor.
Repping my row elite somewhere.
oh, old school. Gone for the classic tee. Right, we're gonna put a plan together and we're gonna tuck in some of these to get us fueled up. Okay, so we've made up a workout. This is it. Ooh. Where is it? Back a bit. So it's 10k total, 5x2k at 22 strokes per minute. Once you've finished a 2k block, you go into 10 push-ups, 10 sit-ups, 10 high pulls. We'll be using some dumbbells from over here. And then some dead bugs to finish off. Once you've finished those 40 reps, jump back on the ergo, another 2k at 22, 10, 10, 10, 10, back on the ergo, 2k, 10, 10, 10, 10. You get the idea.
Oh.
good to go.
On down.
Is that bit done?
Back on you go.
Four more sets.
We're just taking our time. Nice and easy.
Yeah! And we survived. Just. Surprisingly tough.
What?
Surprisingly tough. Matt's just got to finish up his floor work. Couple of press ups, couple of sit ups, couple of high pulls. Oh, well, I zoomed in for a bit. Got the tunes going, as you can hear in the background. All in all, 10k, rate 22. Probably took about 50 minutes, 45, 50 minutes. What time did we start? 10-2?
5-2, I think.
5-2. Started at 5-2-4. Just gone 10-4. Oh. This is where I spent many evenings. Man in the bar, right here. There used to be a sofa here. Shame that's gone. That's where we used to stay every Thursday, I believe. We used to train on Thursdays, and we'd stay behind. We'd take it in turns cooking food for one another, and we'd have a nice big communal meal in here. Have the TV on, play some music, just hang out. That's what got me into the sport, like the friends I made at this club. And the evenings on the Thursdays, we'd sit down and have dinner together. But that's another session done. These sessions don't get any easier. Doesn't matter how much training you do, whether you're a full-time athlete or part-time athlete, no session is ever easy. It is all dependent on how hard you want to push yourself. If I was lazy, I would have taken that easy and it would have been fine. 10K, rate 22, steady state, very nice. But you know, rowers are very competitive people and you always want to go quicker or hold on to maintain. So today was more of a maintain rather than push on. If I would have pushed on, I probably would have died. But good session to bank, lots of calories burnt, mixing up with some floor work, lots of press ups, sit ups, all the good stuff. Now, I've got to clean the machines. If you don't clean your machines, then shame on you, shame. Got to always clean the machines, look after the equipment will look after you. So we're going to do that. And I think we might head to Nando's, head down the road to Walton. Maybe we'll see what's on in the films. It's still early, even though it's pitch black outside. The day is not over. So back at the flat now. I'm actually really pooped. That was actually a pretty tough workout for what it was. Sort of the rest periods between each 2K block was very much dependent on how quickly you could finish the circuit. And because it's only 10 reps on each exercise, you can get through it very quickly. So I think sort of rest-wise, you're probably... I wouldn't say you're having any longer than 90 seconds rest if you're slow from finishing your first 2K and starting the second 2K. So it's 5 2Ks back to back with very short rest periods at a much higher intensity than you would be doing at a steady state. So it was good fun. It was a nice change. Got a good sweat on, got a good workout. And then after that, we went to Nando's, had a good feed. Didn't take my camera with me. I still feel really awkward holding this thing out in public. Every now and then I'll switch to my phone. Even then I feel really awkward and self-conscious talking to myself, basically looking into a lens. But I think I need to slack that up a little bit and get used to it. I started making videos a couple of years ago, and I got into a fairly good routine of trying to show what happens behind the scenes. And then as things got a bit closer to the Olympics, it seemed to die off as I started prioritizing sort of my training and my lifestyle. But it is something that I want to keep doing. I want to try and get back into it from sort of the new year leading into the Olympic Games. I think that would be a very interesting journey, not just for me, but for you. Originally, I wanted to make weekly videos from the very start of season. But the start of season was crazy. It's probably the hardest start to a season that I've been exposed to in my 8 years in the senior team. So I think that just shows how hard Jürgen is pushing us. Because we haven't achieved the gold medal at World Championships this Olympiad so far, he's really pushing us hard because, you know, winning gold at World Championships is great, but winning gold at the Olympics is the end result. And I think it was Steve Redgrave that said this quite some time ago. You know, you're a world champion for a year, but you're an Olympic champion for life. And that's what we all sign up for. We sign up 4 years of our life to commit towards that one goal. And that's what we're all working hard towards. I still want to show the training camps because I think it's important that everyone outside of the rowing community and people in the community who aren't sort of fully involved in the whole circuit, the whole scene of rowing, you can see what we actually put ourselves through. You know, it's not just about that high gloss performance that you see on the TV. On a finals day at a World Cup, the Europeans or the World Championships, there's a lot of hard work and sweat that goes into it behind the scenes, and I'd really like to show that side of the training aspect. I think I'm going to try and keep releasing these videos, not daily, probably not even weekly, maybe once a month if I can, so that's sort of 6 or 7 lean into Olympic Games. They're not going to be super high production value. I just like them to be quite raw, sort of Gold Fever-ish-esque sort of video style. If you haven't seen Gold Fever, go on YouTube, look it up. Great series about the four leading into, I believe, the Sydney Olympics. I really enjoyed it. And that's what I think it should be. I think it should be natural. I think it should be organic. I don't think it should be staged. I won't be recording things over and over again until I get a sentence correct. I just want to say what's on my mind, show you the training, how I am in the moment, chop it all together, try and fit it into a 10-minute video and share it with you. So that's the plan. A couple of days' time, we're into the new year, and I'm really looking forward to that. And let's try and get a few more of these videos out in the new year. So I hope you enjoy. Happy New Year.